Well, do you want the good news or do you want the bad news? Let's start off with the good news. Besides jobs. That's great. Great news. Dangerously close to the end of the system. Now, I say that because I talk to these people. Don't even ask. I don't know how I'm able to talk to these kind of people that are the CEOs and creators of places, but this system is like built on a matchbox. And my brain said matches, and then it went to matchbox. A terrible analogy. I don't know. What do you think? What do you think this system is built on? Trickery? Magic? Greed? Fear? Debt? Right? Keynesian system? There is no money. It's only debt. Yeah, it's bad. Like we built an entire system on sand, okay? And then the system was those Jenga blocks, right? And we just keep going higher and higher and higher, and then other people keep pulling out blocks. Not just jobless claims. Let's see, watch live Robinhood. Oh, CEOs testifying. Like, how do you build a company on, again, a matchbox, right? Oh, hey, let's create a company where we can trade shares for free. And then it starts to go a little bit. And they're like, whoa, we could take out the whole market. We could ruin everything. I mean, everything. Look at our economy. Jobless claims show unexpected move higher. These are initial jobless claims. These people have never been jobless. Where'd you come from? What are we looking at? 800,000? Just guessing. Oh, we also revised up from last week, supposedly. First-time filing for jobless claims totaled 900,000 last week, every single week. Any healthy economy is built on two things, right? Goods and services. And we have neither. We created an entire system, only debt. That is it. A debt-based system. It's not a money-based. I mean, yes, there is money, this money, silver money, gold money, but everything else is just fugazi, right out of thin air. Fed, balance sheets, it's all just, it is debt that you have to pay back in your taxes. And they're just like, oh, here, this year, here's $10 trillion. You want to know what the next one's going to be? $100 trillion. It has to get bigger. It only grows. And your tax burden will also grow. Bravo, no, wait a minute. We have a strong GDP. Did you not see the official BEA.gov data that just came out? The percentage of change every quarter. Look at this. See that big bar, right? You want to know where that bar comes from? You want to know what GDP is now? Stimulus. Here, $10 trillion, right? They print $10 trillion. Digits into your account. Stimulus gone wild. I don't know. That's like a late night show. Everyone gets $10 trillion and that goes towards our GDP. And then when you spend that said $10 trillion, that also goes towards our GDP. And that's why I call it gross domestic pixie dust. No, there is no GDP. We don't produce anything but debt. And I would be kind of excited if we produced jobs. We don't produce jobs. There's no jobs. Yes, oh no. Look at the stats. Okay, yeah. We made government jobs. Okay, good job. So our GDP is government jobs. Our GDP is, also part-time workers. There we go. And this is something that I really need you to get in your head. Okay, here we go. I'll try to make it simple. High school teacher. I try to teach high school level. The government, right, creates $10 trillion this year. Here, everyone, $10 trillion in debt. Didn't do anything. Nothing. No inflation, nothing. Just basically continues to destroy the economy by doing that. Plus, the benefit is you're going to have higher taxes. That $10 trillion doesn't create business. It doesn't create jobs. It does nothing. It actually hurts an economy. And do I see any way out of this? I don't. I do not see it. Well, you guys started the whole debt-based system. And then also, let me get rid of myself. Let me disappear. A little Casper on you. See that GDP now? 131%. Yeah, it's over. When you're at those levels, it's stagflation grinding to a halt. Oh, I know. Why don't we just lower interest rates? Whoa, okay. brought that one to zero. Now what? Okay, give them 10 trillion. Okay. Do you see? It's like we're all the America is on life support, and we just keep doing the same thing. Well, we're not doing the same thing. It works, you know, from 1971. Okay. You know, you had a nice 50-year run. We've come to the end of the game. The game is now over, and the elites know it. So they're like, okay, we got to do a reset because I don't want to lose all of my power. And as this article points out, we were dangerously close to collapse of entire system, says Interactive Brokers founder ahead of GameStop's hearing. And I know these people and I see the fear in their eyes, guys. We have built these platforms on matchsticks. And as he says, what I would like to point out here is that we have come dangerously close to the collapse of the entire system, and the public seems to be completely unaware of it. Yes, including Congress and the regulators. Couldn't agree more. And then, because I have ADHD, I come all the way down to the bottom, blah, 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 blah. I'm still bullish on GameStop, says lawmakers and regulators can solve the current problems surrounding short selling by calling for more frequent data on short selling, increasing margin requirements, or the leverage used on shorted stocks. And I disagree. I agree with you, Jim, though. Jim Rogers says, I don't buy these highs. Okay, Jim, you're smart. Who else? Kathy Wood says that Bitcoin could hit $250,000. One of my high school kids asked me today, Mr. Bravo, so should I buy Bitcoin? I've been preaching it for 4 years in the high schools. One of my kids even traded it, and bought a new car. Sold the Bitcoin. I'm like, it was a girl. I'm like, are you sure you want to do that? She's like, yeah, I'm going to buy a car. How's that car doing now? Yeah. Little missing on the asset thing. But here's what is going on with Bitcoin. When I'm asked, hey, how high can Bitcoin go? I don't know. A million. Okay. How low can it go? Well, it was just at 10 months ago, 3,800. So how does everyone's diamond hands look now, right? When there is fear in the market, which there is not, there is extreme greed. When there is fear, do not And I know I'm going to get this because I've always been a Bitcoin guy, but I'm a realist. I get it. It could go down to 3,800. It could go to a million, one or the other. And then I get the argument, oh, it's just the greater fool, right? Who owns it? Okay, well, fools. We have Tesla. We have MicroStrategy. We have all of these, PayPal, Robinhood, all of these companies are buying it. Now, this is what's even crazier, and I've mentioned this weeks ago, when MicroStrategy, and there's another company, is it Adobe? Another one coming out. I told you which company it was. Maybe I'll do my notes and I'll look. That's going to be buying it. But they're actually, they could have a cruddy company, but MicroStrategy's, what's their PE ratio? Like, but they buy Bitcoin, right? They print bonds, debt, to buy Bitcoin. Stock goes up. And when I look at MicroStrategies over here, MicroStrategies, it's a company, produces a little bit. What are they worth? Market cap, $8 billion, almost $9 billion. How much did they buy? We got, 71? What is that, about $4 billion? If I do the math right, if Bitcoin's at, 51, 52,000, 71,000, 71 times, just mental math here, you're at about $4 billion. So that's great. So half of their company is because they're buying Bitcoin. So now all these companies, which I've said for a while, they're just like, we don't have to produce anything. Let's just buy Bitcoin. Ta-da. Yeah, I don't see this ending terribly. This is not financial advice. I'm laughing. This is sarcasm. And you're still, you're almost getting ready to sell your MicroStrategy. What are you up from my bottom of my buy zone? What did you guys, 72%, 78%? If you're a narcissist and you get the very tippy top, you're 137%. Yes, I have a course on this. If you want to, all these indicators, all this knowledge in my head, and I help you so you want to make money, right? Not lose money. That's what, like, all my high school kids, now we're all in on Dogecoin. I'm like, stop it. But the course is $297 until it goes to $397 and then $497. But, you know, inflation, kids, remember inflation. And since we're talking about Tesla, how's that doing? Okay. Had some sell indicators up right back there. There we go. What kind of a run did you give Papa? From here to there, 108%. I will take it, right? You buy kind of low and you sell kind of high. You just want to get the stoof in the middle. You don't need to get the very tippy top or the very bottom. And I'd say I'm more of a top guy than a bottom guy. Every guy has their own. But think about if all these companies like Tesla and whatever, I don't know if it's Adobe or which one, all these companies are now like, well, since we don't produce a product, let's just buy Bitcoin. Perfect. Just when you thought stock buybacks was the scam, now just wait until all these companies start flooding into this. And you heard it here weeks ago first. And actually, I heard about this on, because I follow a lot of crypto channels. I think it was about a month or 2 months ago that Tesla, maybe 2 months ago, in the back end, they're like, oh, this is going to Bitcoin. I'm like, whoa, that'll pump it. Oh, and bad news, if you own a Tesla here, and if you live in Texas, well, here, I'll say I own in Texas. Texas freeze raises cost of charging a Tesla to $900. Wait till the Tesla owners, right at the end of the month, are like, oh, so what's the electric bill? $28,000 this month. Babe, where'd you go? And I'm thinking there's going to be a lot of bankrupt companies, especially like, you know, you run into the charging stations or what. I don't know. However this plays out, that place is a disaster. So just maybe there might be an importance on fossil fuels. I don't know. You know, when everything freezes and people are like, huh. And some banks, just like this, right here, $100. That's what they've been saying. $100 for oil. One day it's free. No, actually, it was worse than free, right? Just please don't let me take, I don't want to take possession of 100 barrels, right? Options. Oh, sorry. Sorry, Jimmy. Go ahead and send it to Texas. But coming in from more good news. Oh, look at all these solar panels. I got those too. Look at all these solar panels. I don't know. I was it a good idea? Not if I'm going to sell, right? Not so good of an idea. But back to you and not me. Household debt climbs to record. What? You guys are going into debt? Oh, climbs to record. Ah, you're breaking some records. I thought our economy's good. Everything's great. GDP's great. It climbed to a record in U.S. amid surge in mortgages. So here is how the game played out. You ready? You got your stimmy check, you paid off some credit card, but here it is. U.S. credit card balance fell by the most on record. Yeah, okay. You know, give everyone thousands here, 10,000 there. But households increased their total debt by what? Taking on new mortgages, the Federal Reserve Bank of New York said. Perfect, guys. That was basically a Dave Ramsey gave you a big hug and then slapped you in the face because you're like, so Dave, I paid off all my credit cards, but I bought a new boat. But Dave, it's a home equity line of credit. My home will only go up. And we got the full coverage of the U.S. House hearing on GameStop market volatility. Watch. I'm sure meet Kevin's over there with his 6 videos a day. Love you, Kevin. I don't know how he does it. I have no idea. Here's me watching like Maxine Waters talk, right? You're just, really? How long does sliding off of this razor blade in a pool of salt water, how long is this going to take me to slide off? I'm going live. So here we go. The Fed. Ooh, what's the staff say? They're freaking in their pantalones. Fed staff suggest more worry over financial risk than Powell. Well, yeah, because Powell has to put on a pretty face. Powell says risks are moderate. That's even scary. What are you doing saying it's moderate? Bruh, like chill. It's fine. We're totally fine. Staff sees them as notable. Officials insist Powell agrees with staff's overall appraisal. And Yellen, right? Yellen's like, we're fine. We'll never have a market crash in my lifetime. 24 months later, the market crashes. And now which hat is she wearing? Is she over there signing her name on these things? Or is she on the other side that just buys them? And here, you know, like from where I started and I said, we're in trouble from the Matchbox all the way up to the whatever. I'm just taking some notes here. It's all debt, right? Debt-based system. That's not good. You probably don't want to do that. We produce zero. That's not good. And we're not producing. China's beating us. Just saying. No, there's no jobs. We have a million initial ever. Well, okay, I'm sorry. 800,000 every single week. Where did you guys come from? March last year, where that was good. Now we still continue. No jobs. People falling off. And then we cook the books, the numbers. It just, we have more government. We have more control. And then you guys are like, oh, they're not going to take my Bitcoin, and they're not going to do this. I won't let them take my lead and all, you know, all the noise. I know you guys in the comments section. I didn't see you. You know what's been going on? Yeah, you seem to have been locked down, wearing everything that they tell you to wear, doing what they're supposed to do. All of our freedoms, those pesky Bill of Rights, freedom of speech, freedom to gather, all those things, religion. I haven't been in my church in what, a year? Nothing. Everything's closed. Well, no, it's safety. No, it's more government, and it's what's going to be the next one? Bubbles everywhere. Do you not think when one of them pops, it's going to go pop, 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 pop? Our tax burden. Hence why I am proactive. That is why I go to Texas, so I at least can avoid quite a few, taxes, if not Puerto Rico, where you're, what, at 4%, like nothing. Yes, I have to take action. I have to, protect life. And it can't get better. It cannot get better. It has to get worse. And I think that is about three parts gloom and two parts doom. Go ahead and mix that all up and suck it down. I also have Harry Dent on Saturday. I think he'll be on. I will air him on Saturday, and he'll tell you what market's going to correct. I know. You don't have to yell at me. I get it. It's just nice when someone's like puts it out there and calls a number and gives a date. I'm like, all right, bring it. And I want to bring you balance, because what's JP Morgan telling you? JP Morgan banker tells clients, forget about bubbles. And just buy everything. And I say, what the front door? For those of you wondering, we are at the point in the bubble where Wall Street professionals are actively urging investors to buy everything. And then, like always, I tell you, stand as close to the entrance as the exit on my trades, right? I get in, I get out. I get in and I get out. And talk about greed. Look, we're at an all-time fear and greed index. Well, that's for the good old Bitcoin. And I'm pretty sure equities is pretty close to that. So be careful. And also, would you do me a huge favor and do your due diligence? I get these guys on the phone. I talk to them. You know when things are like too good to be true? And then I start moving lots of money into it. I was teaching my high school kids about this one too. And Meet Kevin is now on this bandwagon. Think about this. So my Bitcoin, I'm earning 8.6 APY. I move it over from Basecoin because I do not like them and all the things that they did to me, and they have not said sorry, and they have not given me my money back. Moving it over there, 8.6 on Bitcoin, while Bitcoin goes up. Okay, that's a no-brainer. On a stable coin, regular just dollar coin, still goes up. And they give you $250 if you fund the account. I don't know what the numbers are. I apologize. I don't know. I did it. I'm like, oh, that's a cool $250. And like always, too good to be true, right? Don't you feel that? So we will see. Although it does feel nice to earn interest on my Bitcoin and earn interest on my stable coins. So take a look at that. That's the link in the description. If it works, someone's like, it's not working. I got like a 404 error. Did I say that right? Yeah, I'm like a techie. I should know that. And I know that other guy. I can never pronounce his name. Andre. One of my friends, CoffeeZilla, did a video about him. That was funny. I'm not even going to say it, but it was quite interesting. I'm just, fingers crossed, guys. You know, all my trades, everything that I do, I'm like, this is what I'm doing. I don't know about this one, but take a look. But at the end of the day, learn how to trade first. I think that's my first. Is that a good advice? Start a business first, trade first. Which one? I want to know. I mean, you could take, if you were to take 250 and you just do, same thing with what is it, in my course, not Robin Hood, Weeble. No, whew, dodge that one, right? On Weeble, they give you, what, 3 free stocks? I don't know what they do. And you just take that and you're like, oh, boop, sell. Wait, I did that wrong. No, that's what most people do. Buy, sell, right? Fear, get out. Greed, get in. Because it's just everything when it comes to trading is bass ackwards completely. You're going to want to sell when it's dumping because you think it's going to go so far even more down. People just don't do that. It's like, it's backwards. Trading is completely backwards. And when it comes to equities, I don't feel that bad. I don't have that. Bitcoin, oh, that kicks me right in the coin purse. No matter where I buy or where I sell, I feel terrible. I've bought Bitcoin in the fours, the fives, the sevens, the tens, the anywhere from 4 to 17. Actually, a little piece is where we're at now, which I think we're overvalued, but got to make that insurance policy. But when I sold at 17, right? And then it kept going down. I'm like, oh, that's great. Or when it went into the bear market and I got out, I felt bad. And then when it comes up, it's like, oh, I'm buying too high. Oh, I'm selling too. It's just a terrible feeling. Or when you bought my course at 197 and then it goes to 297, you're like, yes, I think I got a good value. And then it goes to 397 and 497. Like, God, I wish I would have got it then. None of this is financial advice. You lose all your money. But I have been, my life, trade equities, buy assets, stay away from liabilities. Seems like a pretty good way to live your life. Take some risks every single year, start up a new business, whatever that is. I do that. I do maybe 2-3 a year, little ones. I'm like, okay, try that. Oh, fail. Success, fail. Like, all right, we just keep on a rolling. But if you're just sitting there, like in school or in a job, how does that? I don't know. Just not my game. But thanks, guys, for hanging out till the very end, and I will see you tomorrow.